Welcome back to News Geelong as we move into the world of Geelong sport with our very own Mitch Scoop Cleary.
Thanks, Rollo. The Australian Boomers were in town on Wednesday night as they took on Greece for their last match on Australian soil before they head to the London Olympics. We spoke to coach Brett Brown and guard Matthew Dellavedova, who is a future NBA prospect, as he returned to the arena for the first time in 3 years.
We've been waiting a long time for this moment. It's the Olympic Games. Just playing together and playing basketball and getting up and down the floor is a good thing.
I last played here when I was playing with the AIS in the Seville, but I played here as a junior on Friday nights, Bendigo versus Geelong, so it was good fun to get out there again.
You're from regional Victoria yourself. Good to get out in front of the regional fans and give them back something.
Yeah, I had lots of friends and family here, so it was good to see them there.
What have you taken out of the last three games? Great to get a bit of exposure like this before you head over to London.
There's some things we wanted to work on, and we're not quite where we want to be yet, but we definitely got better during the three games.
Can you just give us a bit of background on yourself? I understand you're playing college for St Mary's, same college as Paddy Mills. Enjoying your time over there?
I just finished my third year, so I'm going to, after the Olympics, I'll go back for my last year, my senior year, and it's just a small school outside San Francisco, and it's a lot of fun there.
Going to have good exposure playing in the Olympics against some quality opposition?
I'm looking forward to playing against some of the top players in the NBA and top players in Europe.
What have you learnt playing alongside Paddy Mills and learning from Brett Brown and those sort of people involved in the Boomers system?
I've learned a lot. I'm constantly learning, on the court, off the court. It's just been a great experience so far.
And just back to when you were a junior playing here, you look back on your junior days from Maryborough, fond memories?
We had a shoot-around at MSAC this morning, and I remember in under-12s with Maryborough winning our first Div 3 Vic Country state title, and then coming here when I played with Bendigo and had a few state trainings with Vic Country here, so it's been good fun.
Thanks, boys, and good luck in London. Now we speak to Geelong coach Chris Scott as he put the responsibility of Geelong's poor starts on the senior playing group.
But there are a few things that we think we can do in terms of the way we set up that will help a bit. But really, without absolving the coaches of responsibility, we've said to our senior players, this is an issue and we need to fix it. And they've accepted that responsibility and are striving to get better at it.
Scott said they were still toying with the idea of playing one or two ruckmen as they look ahead to the Sunday's match against Port Adelaide.
Well, we'll keep thinking about it. It's definitely an option. I mean, we certainly didn't bring Dawson Simpson in specifically for one game. He's a long-term player for us. We need to focus on making sure that we play well each week. But we've got a huge focus on developing our players to make sure that we're in a good place in a few years. And Dawson fits well and truly into that category.
Scott denied Matthew Stokes was carrying an injury.
No, he's not carrying an injury. He hurt himself a little bit during the Carlton game, in which he was very good. So that was only 2 weeks ago. And he wasn't great on the weekend. But if you're seeing that, then it's probably reason for me to go and have a look at it a little bit closer.
Thanks, Chris. Now speak to Geelong amateur Travis Robertson as he was best on ground as the Ammos beat Torquay last week at Queen's Park. He snagged a goal and looked ahead to tomorrow's clash against Ocean Grove.
Yeah, look, I've copped a lot of flack for my goal kicking over the last few years, but I'd just like to let everyone know that I've kicked about 8 or 9 straight and no points this year, but I did let myself down earlier, a bit later on in the game. But no, it's good to try and drift down. I don't mind a goal every now and then. Yeah, look, one of the disappointing things of what we've been dished up this year is the fact that we don't play 120 minutes of footy. So we played a good first half and then we played a good 10 or 15 minutes and then we just drifted off and got away from the things that have got us to where we are. So, credit to Torquay, they came back and didn't roll over, but we're able, I guess, three-quarter time probably come at a good spot for us and we're able to regroup and move on.
And finally, 7 weeks till finals and Geelong Ammon has solidified their place in the top five and I feel you'll stay there.
Yeah, look, our aim is definitely to stay there. Look, we've got Ocean Grove next week, and they're the sides, you know, the Torquays and Ocean Groves are the sides we're chasing. So we'll play finals. It's just where we finish.
Thanks, Travis. Now I speak to Geelong's Tegan Caldwell as she has stepped seamlessly into the shoes of Cheryl McMahon for the Melbourne Vixens this season. We spoke to her before she headed across to New Zealand for tonight's clash against the Southern Steel.
Yeah, it's going really well so far, and you know, all the girls want to get out and play, so being given the opportunity to be able to do that's great.
Can you just explain how you went through the levels in Geelong and now find yourself as a professional player for the Vixens?
Yeah, I started playing for Anglesey at the footy netball club there, played all my juniors and then moved into Geelong and started playing in a couple of the GFL teams, which was really good, and then moved up into playing at the State Netball Hockey Centre with the team up there, and then eventually got into the Victorian State team when I was 20 and played that for 2 years, made the Australian under-21s team in my second year, and then it was once I got back from that, then Julie Hornwig, the coach of the Vixens, was interested and wanted to meet with me and offered me a position, and I said yes.
You stepped into Sherelle McMahon's shoes in a way this year. You must be enjoying getting more game time and really having that burden of responsibility.
Yeah, we all definitely miss her, but you know, she's going down another track at the moment, so we're very excited for her, and it has allowed other girls to have an opportunity. So myself and Ash Howard is now coming to the team, and she's doing such a great job as well, and Sherelle's still there for feedback and support, which is really great.
You're getting some nice crowds at High Sense Arena to watch the Vixens. That must really be great for the girls to see that on the weekends.
Yeah, it's amazing the number of people we're getting there at the moment. Our last game was 7,800, and, you know, we can definitely hear them and appreciate it so much, them coming in. Those games where we only win by a goal, it's them who help us get us over the line, so yeah.
What can we expect from Tegan Caldwell for the rest of the year? You've stepped up a level this year. Can we expect to see you in Commonwealth colours in a couple of years' time?
Oh, you know, all girls hope so. So it'll be something I aim for, and I'll just work hard and see where it takes me and, yeah, hope for the best.
Thanks, Tegan. Now, Ian Nicholls catches up with Geelong's VFL player, Andrew McLean, as he prepares to take on Coburg in Warrnambool this Sunday.
How's your form this year? Are you happy?
Not too bad. It's been a bit inconsistent. I got a bit of an injury early on, but yeah, on a string a few good games together, I guess. But the team's been going quite well, so it's
they
been
have.
Pleasing.
Yeah, well, it's very pleasing. First of all, Port Melbourne, of course, raging favourites flag, and then the Northern Blues last week.
Yeah, it was. The Port Melbourne game, obviously, the conditions were pretty similar to the weekend, so that probably helped our favour. We've got a lot of strong bodies and hard bodies that probably prefer the wet conditions, so that definitely would have helped us, but it's very pleasing. Gives you a bit of confidence knowing that you can match it with the best with Port Melbourne. So.
Well, it's good that there's such depth now at Geelong, and you're in the real chance to make the finals and go beyond with the VFL.
Yeah, hopefully. Well, last year was very disappointing. We took, I think, till round 9 or 10 last year to get our first win, and I think we finished pretty strong. But, yeah, this year we're going quite well. Just got to keep winning, obviously. And, yeah, it'll be disappointing if we don't make finals, that's for sure.
Thanks, Andrew. That's all we have time for in sport tonight. Be sure to catch us next week. But for now, it's back to you, Rollo.
Thank you, Mitch. And now for all the weather conditions expected for Geelong and the Surf Coast over the next 6 days, let's look at the week ahead. Tomorrow, Saturday, will be partly cloudy, scattered showers with possible hail and a chance of thunderstorms with an expected top of 12 degrees. Starting off the first day and week of July, Sunday will see cloudy conditions with scattered showers and the chance of thunderstorms until afternoon, accompanied by possible hail and a top of 12. While Monday will be cloudy with isolated showers and a top of 13, Tuesday will continue to be partly cloudy with isolated showers and also a top of 13. Wednesday will also be partly cloudy with isolated showers and, guess what, a top of 13. While Thursday will be partly cloudy with isolated showers and a top of 14. Today it was cloudy with scattered showers and late thunderstorms around the Surf Coast. We reached a top today of 13 degrees. That's another bleak winter weather outlook for Geelong and the Surf Coast. Thank you for joining us on News Geelong this evening. To Bryce Vincent, congratulations, Bryce, on your 200th game tomorrow for St Mary's Football Club. And remember to take your time and smell the flowers. From all the team at News Geelong, enjoy the rest of the evening, have a safe and enjoyable weekend, and a very good night.